For years, I've been bugged by one line of dialogue in Zelda: A Link to the Past. The game begins with a telepathic message. The voice of Princess Zelda calls out to Link, claiming that she is now a prisoner in the castle dungeons. Immediately, Link's uncle leaves their house, sword and shield in hand, and sets off towards Hyrule Castle, warning Link not to follow him. Link doesn't listen, of course, and makes his own way to the castle, using a secret entrance to enter the subterranean tunnels below it. Here, he finds his uncle, slumped against a wall, gravely injured. With his dying breath, the man speaks to Link. "Link, I didn't want you involved in this. I told you not to leave the house. Take my sword and shield and listen. You can focus power in the blade, then release it using the secret technique handed down by our people. Link, you can do it. Save the princess. Zelda is your..." Link's uncle dies before he can finish the sentence, leaving what he meant a mystery. Zelda is Link's... what? What did he mean here? This line has been a topic of debate for decades. Some people assume that the game was trying to set up a twist reveal, and the uncle would have finished with, "Zelda is your sister." Link's uncle dies before he can utter the last word, a trope which appears everywhere in media all of the time. It's used to add mystery to a character's dying words. They pass away just before they are able to relay important information. If this is the case, then it would make sense if the missing word did hint at some major revelation like this. The other popular option is "Zelda is your destiny." Link and his uncle are descended from a line of Knights of Hyrule, warriors who, according to Sahasrara, were tasked with protecting the Hylian royalty. It seems like Link's uncle was also able to hear Zelda's telepathic distress signal as he leaves for the castle immediately afterwards. This would make sense if she was calling out to Knights of Hyrule, those destined to defend her. With this in mind, "Zelda is your destiny" certainly seems more reasonable than "Zelda is your sister," based on the context of the game's story. But can the game's original language tell us anything? In Japanese, this line reads, "Link, if anyone can do it, you can. Rescue Princess Zelda. You are the princess's..." So it's even left as a cliffhanger in the original game. Only the subject is the other way around. This line is just as open for interpretation as in the English localization. This could end with, "You are the princess's brother," "You are the princess's destiny," or perhaps, "You are the princess's only hope." While the original version doesn't offer much clarity, the Game Boy Advance port of the game might. This version of A Link to the Past features numerous alterations, specifically clearer and more faithful translations of in-game text, such as how the seven wise men are now referred to as sages. In this version, Link's uncle instead says, "Link, you must rescue Princess Zelda. Our people are fated to do so, but do not fall victim to fate. Link, I shall always remember our time together." This version seems to clarify the uncle's message and avoid any confusion by omitting the "Zelda is your" line entirely. However, the line, "Our people are fated to do so," seems to add a lot more credence to the "Zelda is your destiny" option in the original game. It appears that, in his last moments, Link's uncle speaks of the purpose of the Knights of Hyrule, Link's lineage. Curiously though, the original line does still exist in this game. In the Palace of the Four Sword, a new dungeon exclusive to this version of the game, Link needs to refight the game's bosses. Blind the Thief, boss of the Thieves' Hideout, impersonates Link's uncle before the battle begins, and this time utters words much more similar to in the original, Japanese version. "You are the princess's..." The decision to not only include the original, mysterious line here, but one more literally translated from the Japanese, is a mystery in itself. Clearly, there was intent behind swapping the dialogue at the beginning of the game, and it seems unlikely that this version appearing in the Palace of the Four Sword was an oversight. Perhaps giving this line to an illusory uncle conjured by Blind the Thief was a way to acknowledge the mystery of the original line. We'll likely never know the truth. But what do you think? Let me know in the comments, and let me know if there are any other smaller Zelda mysteries or details you'd like to see me cover. If you like this video, leave a like, or subscribe if you haven't already for more Zelda content. Cheers guys, and I'll see you next time.